The topic on which I am putting light today is cancer. Let's first go across the definition of the cancer. Cancer is defined as abnormal and uncontrolled division. What is abnormal? Why term abnormal has been used? Abnormal means that generally the normal cells of human body, usually divides into 24 hours. One cell undergoes mitosis to form two cells in 24 hours. That is normal cell division. But if cell divide at other rate than this, this is called abnormal growth of cells. And why it is uncontrolled? Because once it started, it cannot be stopped. That's why it is an abnormal and uncontrolled division of cells that invades. Invade means that will go, they will start to spread to corresponding area and then destroy the surrounding cells. First, what will happen? They will abnormally growth, uncontrollably growth, and then they will start to spread into the surrounding and destroying the nearby cells and tissues. Or you can say that it is an uncontrolled proliferation. Proliferation means division of cells without any differentiation. Means cells goes on dividing without performing any sort of a function. Now, what are tumor and neoplasm? Let's take this new abnormal tissue. The cells formed after the division of normal cells, abnormal division of the cells, those abnormal group of cells are capable of growth. Those sort of a tissue which are capable of growth are known as tumor, in which the tumor grow abnormally and uncontrollably. There are two types of tumor, that is benign and malignant. Benign tumor means the tumor that is restricted to a particular area. That means where has been tumor started, it will try to locate at a particular region and would not be spread any other place. Then the next thing, that is malignant tumor, the tumor which spread from its location to another location is called as malignant tumor. Now we are going to discuss about two types of tumor, that is benign and malignant. Tumors are generally a group of cells that are formed by abnormal and uncontrolled growth of cells. Now there are two types of tumor, benign and malignant. Benign are large localized mass. Localized means that it is restricted to an area, of abnormal tissue. Abnormal means when the cells undergo division prior to 24 hour period, enclosed in a connective tissue. That means wherever the tumor would be, it would be encapsulated by connective tissue like blood or lymph, and it wouldn't be able to get out of there. That's why it's encapsulated, so it is incapable of moving to adjacent tissues, means nearby tissue, and to distant sites, means far off places. Now let's go to malignant tumor, that is non-encapsulated. Non-encapsulated means that the group of cells here is not prohibited by boundaries by all sides, that it is clear to growth and capable of invading distant and adjacent tissue. Means whenever it is, it will start to spread from one region to another region, like this. It will start to spread to another region, and this phenomena by which malignant tumor spreads from its location of origin to the other locations, area of effect, this phenomena is called metastasis. Metastasis means spreading of the tumor from its origin to other places. Now let's go across the symptoms. The first symptom is thickening or lump formation in any part of the body. That means when the uncontrolled division of the cell will occur, it will result in the formation of a lump at that particular region. Second thing is change in the bladder activities, that means bowel habits, means the habit of secretion got changed. Then the next phenomena is indigestion, there is difficulty in digestion of food. Next is difficulty in swelling, means there would be difficulty in swelling the food. Then next, unexplained changes in the weight. The weight changes drastically, that means weight decreases very fast without any reasons. Now get across the types. The types are generally four types: carcinoma, sarcoma, leukemia and lymphoma. Carcinomas are cancer of epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue originating organs like skin, lungs, breast, mucus. Generally, carcinoma includes skin cancer. Sarcomas include primitive mesodermal tissue, that tissue which are formed primitively, means first at mesodermal origin. These are bone, muscles and lymph nodes. Next thing is leukemia. Leukemia stands for blood cancer. That's a simple term used for blood cancer, that is leukemia. Then lymphoma, it suggests with its name that lymph. It affects the lymph system. That means the cancer of the lymph system would be called as lymphomas. Now let's go across causes and treatment. The causes are generally three causes, that are carcinogens, tumor promoter and tumor viruses. Carcinogen are those substances, we take substances which are responsible for activating the genes incorporated into the human genome responsible for the formation of cancer. That are the genes which are present in human genome causing cancer are oncogenes. But those substances which activate the oncogenes are called carcinogens. Generally, chemical and physical agent that causes cancer are called carcinogen. I am giving an example here that nicotine, which is present in tobacco, is generally a carcinogenic substance. Next is tumor promoter. Some hormones and growth factors which are responsible for the normal functioning of the body sometimes results in normal cells to change into the oncogenic, oncogenes. Means some growth factor or hormone that are normally functioning for the development of the body results in the activation of oncogenes, thus causing the cells undergoing oncogenic transformation. Then tumor viruses. Tumor viruses are those viruses which have DNA and RNA as their genetic material, but the oncogene incorporated in their genome are activated, and thus when they attack a human host or take an organism, it viruses DNA or RNA will get incorporated with that host DNA, thus leading to oncogenic transformation. Now let's go across the treatment. In treatment, there is a combination of three processes. That is surgery. Surgery, that is seminal. The part where the tumor has been originated is first of all removed. That is called surgery. Then radiation. Using the radiation of cobalt 60 emitted X-rays, the cells, means after removal of the localized mass, nearby cells which are dividing are destroyed using the radiation. Then last thing is chemotherapy is done. Chemotherapy is the use of anti-cancerous drugs. Means the drugs which can inhibit the cancer. What happens when we use anti-cancerous drug? They generally inhibit the DNA synthesis. And if the DNA synthesis is inhibited or prohibited, the cell division will get abrupted. So the cell division stops. These are the three processes that are used in combination to prevent cancer. Thank you.